Have you not heard it said that it has been prophesied that France shall be lost by a woman and restored by a virgin from the Lorraine marches? Joan of Arc.
The prophecy referred to the rumor that Charles had lost his claim to the throne because his mother, the queen, had implied that he was illegitimate. Joan's presence was so compelling that she attracted a small band of followers who believed she was the virgin referred to in the prophecy. It was now that Joan took a step that would crystallize her image and single her out for all eternity. She cropped her hair in the style of a boy and donned the clothes of a man. By dressing as a man, Joan created an image that was without precedence.
She wasn't a woman, and she wasn't a man. She was this very special, unique thing, a virgin dressed as a man. In a sense, she created a new sexual role for herself that was non-sexual, and it had tremendous power in it.
Arriving in Chinon, Joan sent a message to the castle, asking for an audience with Charles, the crown prince. Charles grudgingly agreed to meet the strange peasant girl in men's clothing. Joan drew Charles aside into a private chamber. Some minutes later, when the prince emerged, he appeared radiant. He was later to confide that Joan had stunned him by revealing information that only God, or God's messenger, could know.